We have videos there of you beating Garlits one time, beating Connie the other time. Which was the more enjoyable?
Which time?
Yeah.
Well, you know, I got a lot of chances to, you know, paybacks are a son of a gun. And I would hold it in, and, you know, and people didn't realize, you know, at least national event fans didn't realize that we battled it out on the off weekends. You know, there were very, very popular races like the famous Pop Hot Rod race in Martin, Michigan, the Bakersfield March Meet, you know, events that were independents, but a lot of fans that came to national events, you know, didn't experience it. I mean, it was like guerrilla warfare, and it was very serious. And, you know, when you're racing Don Garlits, you know, everybody's intimidated somewhat. And this guy, he would, you know, fiddle around and do his thing and get his crew members out of the fans out of the stands. He was famous for that. Then he didn't have to pay that. And then when he chose to get in the qualifying line, it was never a signed position. You had to just go when you were ready and just hope that, you know, you were in time before the time limit was cut off. And he would just blatantly have his guy, Herb Parks, just push him right by the whole line. And he would go to the head of the line like it was acceptable. And I'd scream and holler and stand my ground and stomp my feet. And that's how I, you know, that's how I gained his approval. Boy, he wanted me to go away. he didn't think that, wow, you know, maybe we don't think about this, it'll go away. Well, it didn't. It got worse. And that is what really motivated me. So they all didn't realize what was very obvious. They created the monster.